Today we continue the discussion on high pressure boiler. So today's high pressure boiler is a low flow boiler. In this boiler, the turbines are also used. And the another feature of the boiler is that is the steam is generated is a superheated steam. So due to the superheated steam, there is no problem of salt deposition. Previously we discussed on the Lamont and Benson boiler. The advantage of Benson boiler is that it is a drumless boiler, but in case of Lamont boiler, the difference between the Lamont and the low flow boiler is that low flow boiler can generate the steam with the use of salt water, but no problem of salt deposition. But in a Lamont boiler, it can generate the steam from the salt water, but there is a problem of salt and the sedimentation or the salt deposition. So this is the biggest advantage of the low flow boiler, that it minimizes the problem of salt deposition. So the capacity of low flow boiler is 100 ton per hour at a pressure of 140 bar, and the temperature is again 500 degree Celsius. So next is the working principle. The working principle of low flow boiler is to evaporate the feed water by means of superheated steam from the superheater, and the hot gases from the furnace are used for the superheating. The next is the components. The main components of the low flow boilers are, first is a evaporating drum, then steam circulating pump, then radiant superheater, then convection evaporator, feed water pump, and finally final one is a economizer. Evaporating drum is where the mixture of or the superheated steam is collected and the heated water is there. The steam circulating pump is used for circulating the steam. Then radiant and convection superheaters are there in the combustion chamber. Then feed water pump is used for the feed water purpose, pumping the feed water. And then finally the economizer. Economizer is a preheating device. Now we discuss on the schematic representation of the low flow boiler. So this is the schematic representation of the low flow boiler, where it shows the main components of the low flow boiler, that is economizer, that is the convection superheater, radiant superheater, the pump, steam circulating pump, this is the evaporator drum, and there is a feed pump. So as we discussed previously, the working principle of the low flow boiler is that to evaporate the feed water by means of superheated steam from the superheater, and the hot gases from the furnace are used for the superheating. So here is the combustion chamber, and the flue gases are passes over on the economizer. So we start the working. The feed water, which is coming with the help of feed pump into the economizer, the feed water preheated in the economizer with the help of the flue gases. Means what? From here the feed water goes towards the economizer, and here economizer is nothing but the preheating device, where the water is heated and sent towards the heated feed water sent towards the evaporator drum. Here that heated water sends, and here the water is converted into the steam, and then the steam becomes the saturated steam, and with the help of this steam circulating pump, with the help of this pump, that steam is circulated towards the combustion chamber. Means what? Towards the radiant superheater. There are two superheaters are there, that is, one is radiant superheater and another is a convection evaporator is there. So both the superheaters receive the heat from the combustion chamber and the flue gases, and the steam gets superheated. Then steam is supplied towards the turbine. Means what? Here the saturated steam comes here in a radiation chamber, that is a radiation superheater, that is the steam is heated by means of flame radiation, and then it is sending towards the convection superheater, that is where it is heated by means of flaming or by means of gas, heated gas, and then the steam becomes a superheated steam here, and then that superheated steam send towards the turbine. Then the further which is utilized for the generation of electricity, that steam which is sending towards the turbine is utilized for the generation of electricity, and that steam is only the 1/3 of steam is supplied to the turbine, and the remaining two-third of the steam is goes again towards the evaporating drum. Means what? From here the saturated steam becomes saturated here, and then it becomes superheated here, and then it goes to the turbine. 1/3 of steam and 2/3 of steam is, that's 2/3 of superheated steam is goes to the evaporating drum. Here these are the nozzles. With the help of that nozzles, the steam is comes into the evaporating drum, and again the cycle is repeated. From the feed water, again I repeat it, from feed water, the with the help of feed pump, the water is goes comes into the economizer. Here the flue gases are there. With the help of flue gases, it is preheated. Then that heated preheated water, hot water, is again collected into the evaporating drum. Here it start again mixing with the superheated steam which is already present. Then that steam, saturated steam, is circulated with the help of circulating pump and proceed towards the radiant superheater, where the with the help of flame radiation it is again heated and then sending towards the convection superheater. Here the steam becomes superheated and proceed towards the turbine. That is only the 1/3 of steam, and 2/3 of steam is again proceed towards the evaporating drum. So this is the working of the low flow boiler. So what is the difference between the Lamont boiler and the low flow boiler that we earlier discussed? That is, a low flow boiler can generate the steam with the use of the salt water, but there is no problem of salt deposition. But in the Lamont boiler, we can generate the steam from the salt water, but there is a problem of salt and salt deposition. So that is the advantage in the low flow boiler. Again the applications of the low flow boilers are, it is used in textile, medical industries, marine applications, and power generation. So this is all about the low flow boiler.